Hi, I'm Emil, the practical engineer, and today I'm making a working hourglass lamp.
I'm making the frame of the lamp from some 40mm wide flat metal strip, and I'm using an angle grinder with a cut of this to cut all the parts to size. With a flat sandpaper disc, I chamfer some of the sides. This gives me a nice surface to weld on.
I used some scrap wood to make this rectangular. This rectangular has the inside dimensions of the lamp I'm making, and I'm using it to clamp my metal on. That way it's easy to clamp and it stays square during welding.
After cleaning the metal frame, I applied a few coats of clear spray lacquer to prevent it from rusting. While this was drying, I moved on with the panels of the lamp. I glued the templates on the wood using some spray adhesives and cut them out on the bandsaw. I'm using a thin plate for cuts like this to make it easier to follow the curves. I always try to cut it just outside of the line, so when the cuts are done, I can move over to my sander and sand right to the line. Especially the drum sander attachment for my drill press came in handy with these curved parts. I'm using construction adhesive to glue the wooden panels on the sheet of polycarbonate. It works the best to apply the adhesive to both sides and let it dry for a bit before putting them back together. The parts need to be friction fit, so I'm doing the final glue up in the frame to ensure a nice fit. During the build, I decided to drive some screws as well to make sure the parts would stay in place during the next steps.
This is the round table I made in last week's video, check out the link below. In this build I needed to make these grooves and I wanted to have them the same on both sides and I wanted to have it easy to position. So I added these blocks that acts as a stopper, starter and a stopper. That I can push it here, enter the groove, move it to the other side and they're the same all the time.
These 3D printed hourglass silhouettes guide the light. This way the light can only reach places where the sand would be in a real hourglass, and this makes it look a little bit more realistic. I'm attaching them to the polycarbonate with a few drops of CA glue. You don't really need a lot for a good bond. After mounting the guides, I added these wooden spacers that I made from the cutoffs. These spacers make it possible to glue the front and the back together later. We'll be right back. Okay, let's talk about the electronics for a bit. It all starts with the battery pack. The battery pack has room to move, so when you turn the lamp upside down, the battery pack presses on the switch that turns the device on or off. This Arduino is the brains of the device. It controls these two NeoPixel strips to simulate the falling sand effect. Now all the electronics are in, I can glue the two halves together. I'm doing this while it's in the frame, so I know it fits perfectly.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, I think you will like this video as well. Hit that subscribe button before you leave, and don't forget, dare to experiment and have fun creating. See you next week.